Hello, today I'm going to demonstrate using pulsatile lavage. What this is used for irrigating, typically a pressure wound, anything that's going to be large enough that may have some tunneling. This is a form of non-selective debridement, so it's basically going to be cleaning and taking out all tissue. Both the granulation, eschar, the slough, as you can see it right here, the red tissue, which is the good kind of tissue, that's what we want to see. The yellow tissue is what we want to get rid of. So that's kind of what the aim or the goal of pulsatile lavage is. So, I've already got this connected to the bag of saline solution here, okay? That's going to run down to this exit through the nozzle into the wound bed, which will then get sucked up by this nozzle and deposited into this bucket. So I do have to hook it up, this piece into the bucket here, as well as hooking the bucket up to the machine. Now, the gun piece is actually powered by a battery, so it can turn on, but if you don't turn on the bucket, it won't suck all of the fluid back into the bucket, so you got to make sure you turn on the machine. As you can see, it can be pretty messy. If I was with a real patient, I would probably be wearing a mask, maybe even a face guard just to protect my eyes, even though I've got glasses on. You can see that it can kind of get messy there. And just make sure that your patient is aware of what you're doing. Typically, patients with this sort of wound probably don't have any feeling in this region, but it's always good to check and make sure because this, if they do have feeling, it might be painful for them. And of course, you want to try and protect your patient's modesty with a towel, and then afterwards just make sure and clean up any remaining liquid that has escaped from